फ्रेंड्स लेट्स वी स्टार्ट अवर चैप्टर नंबर 11 ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन एनिमल्स एंड प्लांट्स एंड व्हाट इज द मीन ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन मीन्स इन अवर बॉडी अ वेरियस सब्सटेंस इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अदर प्लेस एंड व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस एंड व्हाट टाइप ऑफ थिंग्स आर दैट आर नीडेड टू बी ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अदर प्लेस इन अवर बॉडी सो दीज सो सच एज डाइजेस्टेड फूड After getting digested, food needs to be transported from one place to other place. Water needed to be transported from one place to other place. Oxygen is needed. Waste material is needed from transfer one place to other place. So this is a transportation. The various materials needed to be transferred or needed to be transported from one place to other place in our body. So that that process we call transportation and what substance helps in transportation of various kinds of material how do digested food water oxygen and waste material in our body transported from one place to other place so these substances are carried out from one place to other place with the help of blood all these substances such as digested food such as oxygen water and waste material are carried out from one place to other place in our body with the help of blood so in this chapter we will study about the blood what is blood and from which substances blood are made up and about heart so and about blood you know that with the help of heart blood is pumped out to whole body and to each part of the body so as heart pump blood to each part of the body so because of this process blood is reached out to every part of the body and so easily with the help of blood all these substances are carried out from one place to other place so next is transportation in humans we will study here transport in humans circulatory system and circulatory system consists blood vessels and heart all these things make circulatory system you know about the blood is a fluid like substance and blood vessels in our whole body blood is flown so and blood flows through a network of tubes which are called blood vessels such as these are the blood vessel this is the blood vessel in which blood flows so blood flows through a network of tubes which are called blood vessels such as these are blood vessels in which blood are flown and heart through the heart blood is pumped to each part of the body and through which because of which one material can be transported from other part because blood flows in each part of the body with the help of heart or with the help of various kind of and various these with the help of these various tubes which we call blood vessels okay friends now next is blood what is blood red color fluid which flows in blood vessels to each part of the body this blood flow in a blood vessels to each part of the body or to each cell of the body as you know our body is made up by the cells to each cells to each cell of the body so this is fluid and that is red color fluid and blood transport what substance blood transport digested food where our food gets digested our food digested in a small intestine and from the, and digested food blood transport digested food from small intestine to each cell of the body so how this digested food gets transported to each cell of the body with the help of blood understood next is oxygen blood transport oxygen from lungs to oxide from body cells to lungs. From lungs to body, what is transported? Oxygen. And from body cells to lungs, what is transported? Carbon dioxide. With the help of blood, oxygen and carbon dioxide is transported from lungs to body cells or from body cells to lungs. So this is the transportation of substances with the help of blood. Next is waste products. Waste product that is formed in our cell, that waste products from the body cells for the removal from the body. So these waste products that is formed in our body cells gets mixed in a blood or is transported in a blood, such as this is blood vessel in which blood is flown. So waste product gets mixed in this blood and transported in the body for the removal of this waste product. So waste products from the body cells for the removal from the body. So this waste product flow in the blood for the removal from the body. Students, next is composition of blood. That from what substance blood is made up? So blood is made up two type of component, fluid component and solid component. Fluid means that the component is a fluid. Such as blood plasma, fluid component, in fluid component, blood plasma comes, and blood plasma is a yellowish in color and contains 90% water. And blood plasma carries water and various materials like digested food, hormones, waste material from one part of the body to another. As we discussed that blood transport materials like digested food, waste material, oxygen from one part of our body to another part, and plasma present in blood. So that type of material is carried out by the plasma that we have discussed about, that these materials carried out by the blood. So these materials are carried out by blood plasma that is present in blood. So blood plasma carries water and various materials like digested food, hormones, waste materials from one part of the body to another. Next is solid components. In solid components, two type of RBC and WBC is present. RBC and WBC comes in solid components, and these are the cells. RBC is known as erythrocytes and WBC is known as leukocytes. And RBC's full form is red blood cell, and WBC's full form is white blood cell. These are all the cells and comes under the solid components and make the blood. So RBC is a disc shaped and small size. RBC is a disc shaped and small in size. So students, RBC is a disc shaped like this type and small in size. And hemoglobin is present in RBC. Hemoglobin, that is red color pigment, and because of this hemoglobin, RBC color is red. And this hemoglobin, as you know that oxygen is transported in our body with the help of blood, and blood consists RBC, and RBC consists of hemoglobin. And because of this hemoglobin, oxygen is transported by hemoglobin because hemoglobin present in RBC and RBC present in blood, and we discussed that blood carries oxygen from one part of body to another part. So oxygen is transported by hemoglobin from lungs to body cells. And average lifespan of RBC, how many days RBC can exist in our body. So RBC can exist in our body about 120 days. Average lifespan of RBC is 120 days, and RBC is formed in our body in in bone marrow. Bone marrow. What is bone marrow? Bone marrow is present inside our bone through which RBC formation occurs. And hemoglobin of the RBC, hemoglobin short form we can write in this type. And hemoglobin of RBC also carries carbon dioxide, which is produced by body cells. And the CO2, carbon dioxide, is carried by hemoglobin present in RBC to the lungs. Okay. Next is we have discussed about RBC and blood. The blood consists two components, fluid components. In fluid component we have discussed about plasma, and in solid components we have discussed about RBC. What the function of RBC is. And next is WBC. WBC is a colorless, irregular shape. It is not a fixed shape. WBC are found in our body having different shapes. Irregular shaped cells, these are. And the main function of WBC is to fight against germs that enter in our body. Such as this is our body, and the germs that enter in our body, and this is WBC cell, and that WBC cell kill that germs and protect our body from disease. So this is the function of WBC. Students, next solid components is platelets, which we call thrombocytes also. And thrombocyte is a colorless tiny shells that is formed in bone marrow. And what is bone marrow? Bone marrow is a part of our bone in which platelets and WBC cells are formed. And next, the main function of platelets is to save our body from high bleeding at the time of injury. At the time of injury, when a high amount of blood having tendency to flow out of our body, at that time, at the site of injury, such as this is the site of injury, dark red clot is formed here due to the presence of platelets in blood. As blood continuously flowing out of our body, so platelets present in our blood, that due to these platelets, a dark red clot is present at the site of injury, due to which bleeding stopped. And this is the function of platelets, that save us and protect us from high amount of bleeding at the site of injury. So in this video we have discussed that how various type of material gets transported in our body from one place to other place with the help of blood, and from what substances blood is made up. Blood is made up by the solid components. In solid components, RBC, WBC, and platelets are come, and in fluid substance plasma comes. So plasma, RBC, WBC, and platelets makes our blood. And what is circulatory system? Circulatory system consists blood, blood vessels. Blood vessels means in which blood are flown, and heart. So these three things make our circulatory system. And what is the function of circulatory system? Circulatory system function is to transport various kind of material in our body from one place to other place. So all these things we have discussed in this video. Thank you.